Hello friends, welcome to NAC Graphics. Following the series of my tutorials, I have covered up this list of chapters so far in a detailed manner. In this video, we will start the chapter of strokes, and I'll be covering up this chapter in three videos. Stroke means the outline of the shape. You can define the color of the stroke from here. You can define the size of the stroke of any selected shape from here. Then we have stroke profile option box. Then we have stroke option box here, having variety of options to work with. You can also have stroke panel docked here like this. And if you don't have it there, you can go to the window menu and select it from there. So let's do some practical, and on the way I'll discuss all the related options of stroke. I will start with drawing a square with 200 points width and 200 points height. Let's make its fill color to be red, and you can see that its stroke color is set to black, which you can also change from here. Stroke size is 1 point thick. You can change the stroke color to be none. In that case, the size will obviously go nil. Now, with no strokes, I want you to notice one thing. Check the size of this square by going to the transform options here. It is showing 200 points width and 200 points height. Even if I increase the size of its stroke to 10, the measurement of the square will be shown 200 by 200 only, because Illustrator does not include the size of stroke while measuring any shape. Now take zoomed look on this square. Right now the stroke size is 10 points, and the thickness of stroke is cut half by this outline. And precisely speaking, the size of square inclusive of stroke thickness is 200 points, plus 5 points from this side and 5 from this side, which comes to 210 points, and same goes for the height as well. While making precise drawings, these type of stroke related issues often come across, which you can solve by aligning the strokes, and the aligning options are available here. First option is to align stroke to center. Next is to align stroke to inside, and last to align stroke to outside. Now in this case, if I want a perfect 200 by 200 size square inclusive of stroke width of 10 points, I will choose its alignment to inside. And now it is a perfect 200 by 200 size square. Likewise, you can choose other options according to the situation faced while drawing. Let's come to other options. The cap option defines the starting and ending style of the path. This option will be applicable to an open path like this, which has independent open and end points. Now notice the points which are ending right over the anchor point, which is known as butt cap. You can change its cap to be round like this, or the last option is of projected cap, which will end up like this, right? Then these next options are for the corners of shape. Like here I select this square, and notice that its corners are joined by applying simple mathematics. This is the first option for the corners to join, which is miter join. Second option is for making a round join like this. And last option is for making the bevel join like this. Similarly, it works with open paths as well, which have corner points like this. Here I select it, and I can choose the corner type for this open path too. Along with this, we have field for limit. It is actually a field for defining the miter join limit, which has a by default value of 10, which is completely read as 10x, or we can say 10 times. Let us get cleared with this topic. Take a look at the corners of this square. In the stroke options, we have selected the corners to be miter join. The stroke width is set to 10 points. But if you check mathematically, the width at the corners is more than 10 points. To roughly check it, I'm zooming at this corner, and now I will draw a line from this corner to this corner, and you can notice that the width shown by the smart guides is around 14 points, which is more than the selected stroke width of 10 points. This is so because we are allowing this miter join to go more than 10 points by setting the limit here. Right now, the limit is set to 10 times, which means that the width at the corner point can go up to 10 times the width of the stroke, which in this case would mean that it can go up to 10 times the stroke width of 10 points, that is 100 points. Now notice if I set this miter join limit to be 1 only, Illustrator will cut down its corner to 10 points only. Similarly, here in this shape, we have more acute corner compared to the square. Stroke size is 10 points, but if I check the width at the corner by drawing a line from this corner to this corner, it is around 19 points because we have set the limit to go up to 10 times the size of the stroke. This thing can be cleared more through this shape as well. This is a closed path and it has these two corner points. The corners are set to the miter join. Now this corner is joined properly within the miter limits, but this corner is not joining properly. The reason here is that it is a very acute angled corner, and if this corner is to be joined with perfect mathematics applied, we have to increase the limit of miter joins here, by which we will allow Illustrator to increase the overall width of the corner by these number of times. So here I am increasing up the limit by selecting this field once and then using up arrow key, and here at 22 times the corners are joined perfectly. But of course it is spoiling our design. So in these kind of situations where lowering down the miter join limit is making the corners look like this, we can select the corners to be round, which you can select from here like this. Similarly, for these two shapes, if we don't want the corners to be mitered, we can make them round, or the third option is to make the corners beveled like this. Alright? So I end up this first part here, and in the next video we will further discuss the remaining stroke options. Thanks for watching NagGraphics, and subscribe for more upcoming tutorials.